Hi Virgo, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and let's do your October read now. Virgo, these are general collective readings, will not resonate with each and every one of you. So take what works for you, okay? Leave the rest. So Virgo, before I begin your read, I'm going to do something different this time. I'm going to be taking one card from this very special deck that I've been waiting for a very long time. In fact, I wanted to start my channel with this, but I couldn't lay my hands on them. And they finally arrived, and it's just fitting that I start my new month with this. This is the Whispers of the Lord Ganesha Oracle. And in fact, Omkara is a name associated with Lord Ganesha. I'm sure most of you know about Lord Ganesha. If you don't, I'll tell you. Lord Ganesha is a Hindu deity god who we pray to for new beginnings, happiness, prosperity, abundance and joy. So let's see what Lord Ganesha has for you and what my angels have for you as well. So the card that's popping out to me for you, Virgo, is Revelation. Wow, you're going to be made aware of a few things in October, it seems. And my angels have play music. There's nothing to be worried about. Spirit says, just take a chill pill. Whatever you've been thinking or worrying about, it's all going to come to light in the month of October. And it's going to put you in a very good space, it seems. Let's see why these cards are here, Spirit. Let's see your tarot reading and we'll kind of see why these cards wanted to show face. So Virgo, let's begin. Dear God, goddesses, angels, spirit guides, please bless this reading for Virgo and send us the messages they need to hear the most at this time. Thank you. So Virgo, welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for all your love. And if you're new here, we welcome you to our Omkara family. We meet here weekly, weekends as well, monthly. If you enjoy the reading, do subscribe to the channel and become part of us. So Virgo, this is going to be a reading which will be 100% focused on you. What your strengths and weaknesses are, how you need to navigate the month going forth to have your best month forward. And yes, I think it's time to pick up that sword and keep it in hand as well. That's why that was at the bottom of my deck. So let's see. Of course, after the reading, Virgo, I will be taking out three cards for your love life and your work life for October. So the first card I have for you here, Virgo, is the Ten of Pentacles. Beautiful. King of Cups and the King of Swords. What a powerful reading this is. Let's see. Before I say anything, I would like to take a few clarifiers for this and then we'll continue, okay? So, Spirit, why is the Ten of Pentacles as the current thoughts right now? Ten of Pentacles is a family card. So, there could be something relating to your family life. Okay. Virgo, is there something you want to close out in your stable foundation right now? You are closing some chapters. There's no love here, or somebody's not apologizing, or somebody wants to put an end to all this immature behavior and find happiness on their own, it seems. And they wanted to shut down some kind of chapter. Is that you, Virgo? Is that your cross watcher? I don't know. Why is the King of Cups here, Spirit, in the recent past? Who's this King of Cups? One more. Something happened here, Virgo, in the recent past where maybe there was somebody in your mix who was not very emotional towards you. Maybe didn't offer you a commitment or there was a problem in a committed relationship. This Ten of Cups that you were hoping for with this person really didn't come about, right? And somebody here withdrew their love. Virgo, this could be you, could be your partner, I don't know. But one person, I think, just withdrew, was overgiving, I think. And was not getting back what they deserved. The other person, I think, was a little emotionally manipulative, was a little, too analytical. There was no love shown back. And even though there were hopes and dreams of having this Ten of Pentacles, I think one person has decided to shut this chapter down because things have really, really stagnated and slowed down and is now going to, I think, go for their own wish fulfillment here. Yeah, putting an end to the beginning, right? If you wanted to start something new, I think things really didn't go well in this situation. Virgo, I'm sorry. So who's this King of Swords now, Spirit? King of Swords? Virgo, you are looking for clear communication. I think you have removed yourself from this situation altogether. You have now pulled back your energy. You are isolated, I think, you're in isolation, or at least you are in deep thought this month in October. And you're looking for somebody who can give you clarity. You're looking for a partnership with equal give and take. I don't think in the past that has really happened with you. Maybe this person was playing mind games with you or trying to kind of always belittle you. This was like one man up ship where it was my way or the my way. There was no highway here either. So you kind of in isolation and trying to heal from the situation and think about this. It's like a revelation, right? What Lord Ganesha said. You're trying to shed light to what this relationship is all about. What is it? I mean, like, do I get anything out of this? I was looking for a relationship where I had a partnership, where I had an equal give and take. But I think this in the month of October, you're finally saying, hey, listen, if I'm not going to get equal reciprocity from you, I'm going to pick up my wand and I'm going to, you know, maybe move to my happiness. You've picked up the sword now and the wand. I mean, you are in... You're trying to get yourself out of this headspace that this person put you in, right? There was too much mind games happening here. You were always stressed out. You're trying to relieve yourself of this unhappiness in this family or marriage. And this person brought a lot of mischief to your life, Virgo. A lot of mischief. The Spirit is saying if you know about it, Virgo, you've understood what the problem is. You've understood... You know that things are not right. It's best to take a chill pill, start living your life. Yeah, don't stay in this confusion anymore. Play music, right? Play music is a card of, I always think like it's time to take a chill pill. I mean, just kind of, you know, get over all your troubles. But in the spiritual way, also, Virgo, sometimes you have to, when you're looking for messages from the universe, just play random music. Sometimes the lyrics of the songs can give you messages coming from the angels, right? But yes, a lot of revelations are coming to your life now in the month of October, I see. And you are becoming stronger and stronger by the day. No longer taking bullshit from anyone, especially in a family dynamic or somebody in a committed relationship or somebody that you wanted to be in a committed relationship with. You're understanding all the games that are being played. So, what should you hold on to? Virgo, hold on to this place where you... can pull yourself out of a troubled time or a troubled place, a troubled state of mind, and you can move ahead to a calmer place. I think the place where you've been in for some time now has been very rocky and very turbulent and very tiring. Yeah, it's time now to, you know, get rid of all this toxicity of people cheating and lying and things always kind of backfiring. You can try and try, but you can't win in the situation. The Spirit is saying, hold on to the fact that there are, you know, happier times are available to you. You can move on to a happier place. You can have full happiness in your life. The Sun is the happiest card in the deck. So hold on to that feeling of joy and happiness which can come to your life. Don't get bogged down by this individual who has always put a damper on your happiness, Virgo. What is it that you should let go of? Let go of always pleasing others with the Three of Cups energy. Let go of, if I don't do good or if I'm not part of celebrations with this person or if I'm not always showing the best face forward, things are going to blow apart, right? Stop doubting yourself. Stop being subject to other people's moods and happiness. And that feeling that you know, it's never about you and you can never make a choice in the matter. You have to let go of that feeling altogether now, Virgo. It's whatever you choose to do, you are fully capable and fully allowed to do. You have to let go of the sadness and regret and depression that you feel from when you look at past memories, it always makes you sad, it seems. So spirit is saying it's time to let go of this. In the month of October, pick yourself up and know that you are stronger than you think. Let's see what is going to be your biggest hurdle this month, Virgo. Your biggest hurdle is going to be the Six of Wands. Feeling a feeling that you can never win. You can never win. Victory is your biggest blockage. So, you know, it's like the fear of success. What if I can actually get away from this toxic place or a bad environment or a bad family situation? Even though sometimes you know you can achieve it, you stall it, right? Because you fear abandonment. You don't want to be left alone. You don't want to be sad and alone. You feel you'll never make it to the next level. And you'll never win in life, maybe, if you are not in the circumstance that you're in. You have a fear of that. You have a fear of succeeding, it seems. And that keeps you in this place of always feeling abandoned and left out in the cold. How do people see my Virgo now? They see you as to always having to make a decision, but maybe never making it. Here you are. Eyes are blindfolded. You have your swords over your chest, over your heart, not allowing your heart to speak, not letting your eyes to see. And people view you as that you always kind of close off and always feeling overburdened and yet never making that choice. Yeah, people also see that, you know, the situation has come to quite a stagnancy in your life. Whatever you're worrying about, whatever you're thinking about, Virgo, people do see that this situation actually is offering you nothing. But you are also needing a lot of healing from whatever has happened in your life. This you very, very burdened, yet having to make a decision which somehow you never end up making. What's Spirit's secret advice to you now? Spirit's secret advice to you, Virgo, is that you have so much love surrounding you. Why are you fearing? Why are you fearing finding that success for yourself and being in a place which makes you unhappy? What is the Ace of Cups for Virgo Spirit? What is the Ace of Cups? Why is the Ace of Cups here for Virgo? Virgo, it seems that there is somebody around you who is a bit emotionally manipulative, right? They may love you, or at least they claim to love you, but they are also emotionally playing on you so that you never go for your new beginning, right? This person is keeping you stuck all the time. But the point here is, Virgo, you can have stability, happiness, joy on your own. You don't need anyone, because there is so much love waiting for you once you make a decision to find that stability within yourself. This is what you need to be. But there is somebody here, Virgo, who is keeping you stuck with offers of love which are actually maybe not true love. Let's take three cards for your work life. What do we have now, Spirit, for Virgo's work life here in the month of October? Ace of Pentacles, very nice. Thank you. Virgo, again, the fear of being left out in the cold. You have everything going for you. The Ace of Pentacles is here. But somehow, you always fear that it's all going to come to an end and you are going to be left out in the cold. You have to have confidence in yourself, Virgo, this month. Let's take some clarifiers. Ace of Pentacles, Spirit. And one more card for the Five of Pentacles. Virgo, you know that you can have this fresh beginning. Things are moving perfectly well for you. You have enough, right? You've worked very hard for this success that you, I think, already have, or are you are still working towards that. But somewhere, Virgo, you have a fear of lack. You feel it's all going to blow up and all going to end one day and you'll never have it all. There is a bit of a scare within you. There's a bit of scare of the lack mentality that you're going through right now, and you feel that any move that you make to have maybe a fresh beginning, it may not last. Your abundance may not last, or you lose money. And Spirit is saying that's absolutely rubbish, because all we want to give you is a balanced life, right? Angels are saying there's lots of healing that we are sending to you, but you're not taking it. We are waiting here to make your life balanced. You have new beginnings coming. We will provide for you. This fear of losing it all is keeping you stuck in a place where you're not taking any chances with your life, it seems. So if you can get a message and learn from this, Virgo, it will really serve you well. So what do we have for Virgo's love life now, Spirit? In the month of... Okay. In the month of October. Wow. Virgo, you are shining this month. You're shining this month. You are looking gorgeous. You have the Queen of Wands energy, which is not a feminine or a masculine card. It just means that you are dynamic. You're looking good. You're handsome. You're beautiful. People have eyes on you. You are going to be able to manifest anything that you need. You have to just choose a person and they'll be all over you, I think, because you are heading for a fresh new beginning in your love life. Right? Or if you already have somebody that in your mind, you're going to have a fresh beginning with that person. Let's see, what's this Queen of Wands? Queen of Wands. So be careful what you manifest, Virgo. You're going to get that person, it seems, in October. Wow, beautiful, beautiful. You're going to be in control of your love life this month, Virgo. If you were dealing with somebody who was immature or irrational or a player or whatever, you are manifesting a brand new beginning. You are ending any kind of conflict from your life. You will be moving ahead, manifesting new people in your life this month. And yes, you will have a fresh beginning and you're going to be victorious. Excellent. Excellent. I think you're going to move ahead. I think you're going to have these revelations of all these things which are keeping you tied to the past, Virgo, and you're going to break free and you're going to go for this new beginnings, which is going to get you love, money, abundance, everything. Because you have it all within you. You don't need anyone. You're the magician, right, of your own life. All the tools are here with you. Somebody in your life is keeping you emotionally stuck and making you feel that without them in your life, you are going to fall, which is absolutely untrue. So, and this revelation, once it kicks in, there's no looking back for you, Virgo. I'm assured of that. So hurry up, okay? Hurry up and take your life back in your hands and move forward to new beginnings now. You have two cards here of Ace of Coins, Ace of brand new beginnings. But one of them was in reverse because you're not moving ahead. The gifts are there, grab them. Okay? That's all I have for you. Till next week then, or this Thursday for your love bite. Love and light. Take care, Virgo. Namaste.